My name is Steve Kirschenbaum, founder and CEO of SAT Preparation Group. I want to personally thank you for taking the time to learn about the basics of the SATs and ACTs. Theoretically, you can take the SATs and ACTs as many times as you want. However, it's probably a good idea to keep it down to about three times each to prevent SAT-ACT burnout. Colleges used to be a lot stricter about the number of times an applicant took a test, averaging scores after three or so attempts, which effectively lowered the score. But today, with vast amounts of data collected from our own students, the colleges, including the Ivy League schools, simply take the best composite scores of whatever test, SAT or ACT. That would justify a student getting accepted. We've had a plethora of students over the last 10 years accepted to Princeton, Yale, Cornell, Michigan, Florida, and a spectrum of others who took the SAT or ACT more than three times and did just fine getting in. In fact, one of our college counselors called the dean of one of these major universities, and he unequivocally told us that they could care less how many times a test could be taken. Let me say this, though. If you start early and have sufficient preparation so you know exactly what you're doing, there's no need to take the SAT or ACT more than three times anyway. But if you do, it's no big deal. If you'd like more information, I have 20-plus free SAT-ACT videos on frequently asked questions and lots of free content on life skills for teens and young adults that I'd love to share with you that will answer virtually every question you have about preparing for these difficult standardized tests and the real world. If you go to youthquest.org or prepsattest.com and click on the blog link, you can easily sign up and get all of them. Make today and every day a wonderful adventure.